It's 12 o'clock on a Wednesday and this is the Wizard Magic Review. I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
He's back.
I'm for one night only.
One night only. He's back in the country. How's it going?
It's going amazing. Doing card tricks for 1,000 people a night. And they're loving it. What, living my dream. I love it.
All these illusionists getting on the ship with all their flight cases. Sean Heydon, I'm here.
Got a Tesco bag with three packs of cards in it.
You're doing the Coke cans as well?
Doing the Coke cans as well.
Still all got the Coke cans.
All the big stuff.
First up this week, Sean is joining us back for one show. This is the show before Blackpool.
Yes.
So we've managed to get hold of a couple of items that are kind of like exclusive for Blackpool, some brand new items. We'll be talking about those, kind of like a first look, not really a review, because we didn't have time to go through the whole thing with a couple of reviews.
Which you'll understand why.
Yes,
when we get
we'll explain,
them.
But it's a good thing. It's a good thing. But first up is a brand new item from Malcolm Puck Pickering. Puck, synonymous with sort of performing with Scott Alexander over the years. They were like a double act and that kind of thing.
Yeah, and I remember watching him as I was growing up performing magic on cruise ships, and he's got some really great stuff.
Yeah, and this really is an unbelievable thing, isn't it? But we are just going to do it. We're going to do the whole thing. We are going to set it up.
Let's say he actually performs this as part of a motivational, inspirational speech. Now, we didn't want to plagiarise Puck, so we've actually contacted one of the most intelligent presences in the whole of the world, one of the best script writers in the world. It's Mr. ChatGPT.
Yes.
And it's written a script for us. We don't know how it's going to play out, but we're going to inspire you with a script written by ChatGPT.
Yeah, because...
And Puck's new effects.
Yeah, Puck. This is Unbalanced, presented by Puck and Audio 8. We are going to perform it. He used it to close his shows at the Magic Castle, as well as that motivational. So you perfect. I haven't heard this.
I've got the script here on my phone.
Are you going to try and time your speech with what I'm doing?
I'm going to try to. And we're going to motivate you magicians.
Why wouldn't you let me see it?
I've not even read it properly. That's the main reason why.
Right.
We're going to have some inspirational music.
Yeah, we'll cue the music.
Cue the music.
There you go.
Tell me when you're ready.
Go.
Welcome to a moment of enchantment where impossibility transforms into a breathtaking reality. Today, I invite you to witness a spectacle that transcends the ordinary, a symbol of resilience, balance, and the magic inherent in life's delicate dance. Before you, I have an array of seemingly unrelated objects, each representing a facet of our diverse experiences. As we embark on this journey together, consider the parallels between my act and the intricate tapestry of your own existence. Life, like the delicate art of balancing, demands our constant attention and focus. The challenge lies not only in keeping things aloft, but in finding harmony amid the unpredictable winds of change. Yet, it is precisely within this delicate equilibrium that we discover the true magic of living. Now, let this act be a metaphor for the fragility and beauty of life. As we stand on the precipice of uncertainty, remember that sometimes the most extraordinary moments arrive from the graceful acceptance of imbalance. And now, prepare yourselves for the crescendo of our shared journey. Witness the collapse of the majestic descent, a reminder that embracing the fall, we open ourselves to the transformative power of new beginnings. For it is within the ruins of what was that the seeds of something even more magical are sown.
Thank you very much. Good night.
It's amazing.
That is incredible, isn't it?
It really is incredible.
It reminds me, I tell you what, Alex Ramone, a friend of mine, great, he's been on Foolers and that kind of thing. He actually does a version of Balance, but a giant version with his dog.
Yes, I've seen. It's incredible.
On Foolers. And, you know, he has kind of like ascertained that one of the strongest things about the routine that was missing from that kind of Joshua Jay original presentation
is the dog.
Was the fact that it all collapsed at the end.
Yes, it's
and
amazing.
The fact that everything collapses, you build it all, and like, sorry, Puck, if I didn't do it justice, but literally, the amazing thing is, we opened this about an hour ago. We've watched the tutorials were very concise. The equipment...
It's incredible.
Yeah, it's absolutely first class. If you would have put like a few hours, like practice time into this, you would be able to do this incredibly smoothly. It just works. It's made by the team behind so Audio 8, Charles and Charles Peacock and everybody there. It is technology. It is incredible thinking. And the fact that it gives you that finish.
Yeah, it's a really good finish. It, and of its type of trick that's available to buy for us magicians, it's the best.
Yeah.
It really is.
It's not cheap. It's just under £500. But like Sean said, there's your quote, Puck, by the way. It's the best version of the balance
100%.
Effect.
It really is.
It is unbelievable. The fact that it all falls apart, similar thinking to Alex's thinking with the stage show routine, the fact that it all falls apart at the end just, you know, disguises the method behind it.
And it's artistically, it's beautiful as well, because it's the magic suddenly broken.
Yeah.
It can be broken at any point. Yeah, it's really great.
It's difficult to grade. I'm not sure I'm going to use it, but... Do you know what? I'm glad that I've got it. I think that I'll use it at some point. Or
are we grading it?
Yeah, I think this one, yeah, we can grade
this
one.
I'm going to grade it. I'm going to go straight in at 100%.
Yeah, it has to get 100%. The moment we set it up, it's the best version of this kind. We set it up and we did what you needed to do to make it happen and we both just went, wow.
And everything's been so... When you watch the instructions, the tutorials, and he explains everything that he's thought about, you suddenly realise that a lot of work's gone into this.
Yeah, it really is good. Everything's contained in the box. You've got all the bits. Everything just works flawlessly. And it's not that hard to do it. You just follow the steps. It just works by itself. It's the best version of the balance effect out there. It's brilliant. Literally hot off the press, released very recently.
Minutes ago.
We only got it this morning. We have literally watched as much of the tutorials as we can. There's quite a lot of tutorials.
Probably the most comprehensive
tutorial
for a magic trick I've ever seen.
Ever. And but what we did, we looked through the first hour.
Yes.
And over the first hour, Craig goes into everything that's kind of possible.
Yes.
And then it's fair to say the next sort of few hours or so elaborates on these possibilities with guest performers. We will talk more about this in a moment. But first, we will talk about the performance. can you do just like a basic routine with it and explain what it is, Sean?
I'll introduce what it is first. Yeah. So very popular on social media now are these inspirational quotes and affirmations to help motivate your day.
Yeah.
And so Craig has brought these into an inspirational pack of cards. So we've got different things that are on the cards that might mean things towards your feelings, like zest, yuck, that's not a good one, xenophobia, wonder.
Doug Henning.
vanity.
Yeah. Can I identify with that?
Yeah, you get that. Upset. trust. But you've got sincerity. And they're accompanied with a picture, an inspirational or a not so inspirational word, a quote, and the person who made the quote. So we've got Johnny Depp on this one, something that he said. And it allows you to, I suppose, do pseudo psychic readings.
Yeah.
And it allows you to give multiple readings and lots of different tricks, more than you could possibly imagine.
Okay.
But Dave, we're going to demonstrate one of the tricks.
A basic demonstration.
A basic demonstration. So you're going to give the spectator the cards and you can choose how many times you cut the cards. As long as you cut and complete the cards, you can do this as many times as you like whilst my back is turned, Dave.
You're going to turn your back?
Yeah, my back is turned. Cut and complete the cut, and then you can do it again if you like. It's completely your choice. And then you can cut and complete the cut again.
Okay.
And keep doing it.
Keep cutting.
Keep cutting, and then stop whenever you like. When you're happy, you then get to choose either the top or the bottom card. It's completely your choice. And put it somewhere I can't see. Sit on it, put it in your pocket, and just tell me when you have done that.
Right, shall I show the camera the card?
You can do. You can keep it for a surprise. You can show them. It's completely up to you. But tell me when you've got it hidden away.
Right, it is completely out of sight.
It's completely out of sight. Now, here is the thing. There's no way I could have known how many times you're going to cut the cards.
No.
There was no way I could know what the top or the bottom card was going to be. And in fact, if you were sitting on, say, the top card instead of the bottom card, or the bottom card instead of the top card, the choice would have been different. It was your choice the whole time. Now, I want you to think, did you see the card?
Yeah.
I want you to think about the main word on there, the main meaning on there, okay? You can have a look, don't let me see, okay? The title of the card, if that makes sense.
Okay.
And I want you to think about how that makes you feel. Now you I'm getting freshness and maybe fruity fresh, maybe,
yes.
Maybe would the word lemon mean something?
Yes.
And what would you associate with lemon? Not lemon cake, lemon zest.
It is.
It's the word zest.
It is the word zest, a joyful sort of word.
Yeah.
That really is only a very basic presentation.
A very crude, basic
demonstration. Yeah, and we do have to stress this, because there is so much, with a capital S-O, so much.
It's ridiculous.
You can do with this.
It is amazing.
Like the trailer's about, I think it's longer than that Scorsese movie, the trailer. It's like an 8-minute trailer.
You get,
everything you can do with this effect.
A tutorial, so I think you get 9 different videos, amounting, I think, over 10 hours of tutorial.
That was only a basic sort of presentation. Let's go over a few of the things that you kind of can do with it. Obviously, it's got its own unique sort of marking system, which is genius, isn't it?
Yeah, it is incredible. And when we say marking system, you might akin this to a pack of cards, where you look at the cards and you go, that one's the Ace of Clubs. This system as like a multifaceted system that probably allows you, gives you lots of different type of information just from the markings on the back of the cards.
Yeah, and there's different reveals. The images that are on the cards themselves, it's kind of like a Quran principle, and that can help you to reveal whether it's a positive or negative emotion. You can look at the author of the quote. You had quite a good idea with the authors, because what you could do, you could give out groups of cards to different people. And you mentioned the Barry Richardson
has a book called Theatre of the Mind. And in that, I think it's called A Night at the Opera or something.
Oh, really?
And you hand out all these groups of opera tickets. And people, each person shuffles groups of opera tickets. And then they think of one of the tickets that they remember. So somebody that they know.
So they'd be remembering who the person
was. Yeah, like Pavarotti or whoever. They remember that person.
They'd remember who the quote was on the card.
And then one by one, you reveal which person each spectator is thinking of. And then you get the final spectator to think of a song sang by that person, mm-hmm. and you reveal that as well.
It's fair to say, Craig's probably thought of that, because there's like hours upon tutorials.
Sure we've not watched the 10 hours, so I'm sure it's on there. We've just watched the first hour, but I immediately thought, what a great
every
use.
Card, let's show a card to the camera. So Xenophobia, you see every single card, it's got the author. Then it's got the actual word representing the feeling. Then you've got the image, whether it's positive or negative. But then there's a quote underneath. And you can get the spectators to think of one word in the quote using a well-known principle in mentalism. You can very, very easily define the word they are thinking of on any one of those cards.
100%.
There is so much you can do with this. It really is a mentalism toolbox. But the main thing that I want to say about it is how good the cards look. They really do look like what they're meant to be, which is 30, as it says on the packaging, 30 motivational cards. Even the box that it comes in, it looks genuine. It looks like something you would get from the Works bookshop, something you would pick up to, you know, help you find your spiritual side or whatever you want to do with these cards.
Even the box is part of the tools for you to perform some of the effects.
Yeah, it aids. It means that you don't need to use any memory work at all. We've kind of rushed this onto the show, but what we do want to say is this is like a first look. We're very impressed, aren't we?
You also don't just get these, you get two other cards as well.
More cards.
Which I won't... this card specifically helps you to perform a routine where somebody would maybe read a card.
Like an NLP routine.
An NLP thing. And then you make them forget how to read and they can only read nonsense. This is what helps you to do this. And this one here is part of an NLP routine, which Craig explains incredibly articulately, but essentially...
Reducing
somebody's anxiety. Yeah, it's a very clever idea.
Yeah, there's so much. Congratulations, Craig. It's an amazing... I think, do you know what? I don't know if I can say this, but I think it's probably Craig's best release.
I think it's Craig's best release. And also, if you're doing corporate events and trade shows, mindfulness is a huge thing as well.
Yeah.
It's right on target. And what I like about it is you're not repeating the same trick twice. So you could carry these around with you at an event or socially. And every time the same person said, oh, do that trick again with the cards, you can do something different. And so you're never going to get tripped up without people watching the same trick too many times.
Yeah, mentalists will take their routines to another level because, like you touched on at the start, you can do effects with playing cards. But as soon as you start bringing people's emotions and their feelings into it, it's got a whole new level of hook.
Absolutely.
For that spectator. Yeah. Suddenly the whole thing becomes about them. And that's what's important.
Well, you can also present yourself differently. So you can come at this, if you wanted to, I'm not suggesting you do, you could come at this almost like a therapist.
Like a tarot reader.
Like a tarot reader type thing. And you know, Peter Taylor does this incredibly well. And he's on the DVD. So on the download, you've got Ian Rowland. You've got a whole hour and 38 minutes,
what
I think, of
Ian Rowland doesn't know about cold reading.
No.
It's not even worth knowing. No. And Ian's contributed, Peter has contributed, Peter Nardi has contributed, you know, some top mentalists. Ian is the world's leading expert on cold reading.
Absolutely.
There is so much to gain from this product, not just the actual cards themselves. You're going to learn so much. Congratulations, Craig. I'm sure you're going to sell out at Blackpool. That's just a first look at Evoke by Craig Petty and produced by Murphy's Magic Studio. I'm sure I don't need to tell you that Blackpool is nearly upon us. I do want to let you know as well that myself and Wayne Fox, the Monday before Blackpool, so the same week as Blackpool was starting on that Monday, we're doing like a presentation at Northamptonshire Magicians Club on the Monday. So if you're a member of Northamptonshire Magicians Club, it's a special night on the Monday. I'll put the date on the screen right now. And myself and Wayne Fox will be going through all our latest products. It's a special night just for Northamptonshire Magicians Club members, but guests are welcome. For the guest fee, I think it's £10 or something like that.
And I've got to say, the Northamptonshire Magicians Club is fast becoming probably one of the top local magic clubs in the country.
It's certainly one of the biggest regular attendance.
Yes,
the dinner is sold out.
And you've got the people, can we say who's at the dinner? You've got big names.
Jamie Allen is at the dinner this year. We're presenting
incredible.
The Scott Penrose Award. There are lots of things
incredible.
Going on. And then in 2 years' time, we've got the Centenary Convention, which they've convinced me to put together and base it sort of on the lads' format.
Okay, that's going to be
so
great.
So we're going to have the Centenary Convention, which will be in a couple of years' time, and we're putting some international lecturers together. I've got at least four new releases for Blackpool, possibly five, and I've just got back from China a couple of weeks ago, and there's some great items. Had a great time working with the TCC team, putting these projects together. Over 2 years of work, actually, to get to this point where we're releasing these products now for Blackpool 24. We'll be in our usual place on the balcony. But remember, if you're free, that Monday night, just before Blackpool, before we all get down there at the weekend, earlier on in the week, if you want a preview of all the products that I've got coming out, come to that night at the Northamptonshire Magicians Club. If you're in the area, I'll be demonstrating everything, including my brand new deck.
And it's very good. I don't want to say anything. It's brilliant, though.
Which I've actually done in association with Mark Spellman. Mm-hmm. That we've collaborated on the same deck, and it's got some unbelievable things that you can do with this just one deck of cards. It's like the 52-1 deck on steroids. It's unbelievable, and I'll be showing it for the first time at that night in Northampton. Another release from Hanson Chen's Black Holder series right now. This is the 20 half-dollar dropper. Well, that kind of explains everything that it does. Thank you very much.
That's the end of the review.
It just does what it says on the tin. It's as simple as that. We've looked at the quality of the gimmick. You get kind of like an online tutorial. How long was the tutorial on?
18 minutes.
18 minutes of tutorials. You do get like a quick start guide, so immediately you can be ready to go with the holder. But it is exactly what we've just described.
It's more than it says on the tin, actually. Because as it explains, you can fit 20 half dollars in here, or you could put anything in there. So they say you could put jelly beans in there, you could put mints, but anything that you want to put as a final load. Obviously, what springs to mind here would be the final load for A Miser's Dream. Now, the way you set it is very simple. You put your dollars in, you put your load in.
Half dollars,
and then,
yeah.
Your half dollars in. And it clips in. It's now securely in here.
So
nothing's
locks
coming
them
out.
In a box.
Locks them in a box. And then you have this loaded in your desired place where you hide
down
your
the
things.
Side of the body, yeah.
And then what you do to unload it, you'd come up. I can't do it at this angle, but you come up, and the thing actually releases itself just like this as you're coming up.
So obviously, your hands kind of cupped underneath, yeah. Ready to receive the load. And what would be an unbelievably difficult load to steal?
But like say, for this camera, that would say be here, and it's in the perfect situation for you to come up. You clip down here,
press
and then
down
every,
with your thumb.
Press down with your thumb. Everything's then out here, ready for you to load in your desired magical device.
And obviously, you're not limited to one. You could have one, two, three of these. If you wanted multiple loads.
Oh, absolutely.
During,
it's really clever.
There's not a lot to say during
It's a
review.
James Bond magic device.
It's a James Bond magic device that allows you to steal 20 half dollars or whatever else, coffee beans, whatever else you want to completely fill up your hand ready for that sort of final cascade at the end. Naturally, on the tutorial, we've got loads of guys actually demonstrating it flawlessly. But it is what it is. It is just a holder. It's something brand new. It does work incredibly well. You're just pressing that at the side. It immediately opens.
That's it.
Ready to receive that load. The Black Holder series, it's got some clever stuff, hasn't it?
Do you know what I want? When at the beginning of the trailer, they open up this case, and it's got like
I know what you're going to say.
For different things. It's like you feel like a magical hitman.
You want,
I want
that
whole
case.
Collection. Where can I get the case from? That's what I want. And I want all the holders in it.
And you just want to walk and go, right.
And I walk this one today. Like you're like a hitman walking into bed.
And then you put them all on you.
Clip that in.
And you walk into the gig like a Terminator. Ready to go. Sponge balls. 20 half dollars. Absolutely everything.
That's it.
And you're ready to go. It's just a first look. I'm sure Hanson will have a stand at Blackpool. You'll be able to check out this and all the other holders.
And see the case. I'm sure the case will be
bring
on
the
there
case,
in
Hanson.
Its full glory. Yes.
But yeah, just a first look. The whole Black Holder series will, of course, be on display in Blackpool. Finally, this week, Kevin G has sent over for review, and I'm sure he's going to have these on his stand at Blackpool. H3 by Henri Beaumont. It is kind of like a book test, I think it's fair to say. A very advanced book test, what looks like a book that Rubik Cubers would have.
Yeah, so it's got lots of bits of information in it. For example, it's got different names of Rubik's Cube people and where they're from, how fast it got them, took them to solve the cubes in certain positions. Also, the solution, the algorithm that they used to solve the cube, which allows you to perform lots of different effects, such as...
Well, there's some more facts. There's over 100 pages. It starts off kind of talking about the history, doesn't it, of Rubik's Cubes. So you've got the history to start with. So it looks like a regular book. Like Sean said, the event where the record was set, the name of the cuber who made the record solver the cube, their country, where they came from, the time it took for them to solve the cube, the algorithm. And there is so much information on one page, but it is a book test.
Yes.
It's not a regular book. You can use this book in the middle of your Rubik Cube routine to do some unbelievable mind reading. It really is unbelievable because there's no memory work as such involved. It's kind of nicely cribbed, but there's so many reveals that you can do. You can reveal the origin of where the cuber's country of origin, where they actually came from. The starting position of the cube, and then you could replicate this, even though you don't need to perform it with a cube. You can use it with a cube or without a cube. You can reveal the location of specific colours. You could reveal the time they took to solve the cube on this occasion and the number of moves that they took to solve the cube. Now, you don't have to use a cube. You can use a cube. It's completely up to you.
The nice ending would be that you had the cube as a prediction or were able to put the cube into that position at the end and then solve it. But you can just do the mentalism bits from the book should you not want to use a cube.
Yeah, I think comparing it to a book test, obviously in a book test situation, you are normally revealing one word. But the fact that you can have a spectator open up this book, look at a random configuration, a cube solve, you get them to concentrate on it, and then you can actually recite the algorithm that they're looking at, you know.
Which is exciting.
That's more amazing than just a single word revelation.
Obviously, all the algorithms are a different amount of letters, but to take this randomly, you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, about 15 letters, the random letters that you can start off slow and build and build and build to sort of a big crescendo at the end.
You've got to think about who this is for, obviously. You're not going to get people's attention at a corporate event when the music's blaring and that kind of thing. But if you're doing a presentation where people are really focused and you're portraying yourself as an expert in Rubik Cubes, you don't just want to do like a solve and that be the end of it, but you're portraying yourself as somebody who studies Rubik Cubes, that he's an expert in Rubik Cubes, you're going to want to pick this up.
Oh, absolutely, because, you know, for example, you could be portraying yourself as, you know, when I first started learning the algorithms from Rubik's Cubes, this was one of the first books that I've got, and I've studied it front to back for the last 10 years. It's got all the different algorithms of the famous cubers, and then, if you're going into it from that standpoint, you're then proving that it's almost like a memory test.
You can actually portray it as memory. Yeah. You could do it as a prediction. There are lots of different ways that you could actually decide to play this as a performer. But I think the fact that... The bookmark as well, it's very clever.
Yeah, bookmark is very, very good.
The actual fact that you can insert this in the middle of a routine, it's got a different feel because a different prop has been introduced, but it's still cube-related. You're able to extend that existing Rubik Cube routine that you might like to perform.
And it takes a bit of knowledge that spectators have and it uses it against them. For example, people know a little bit about Rubik's Cubes, know about these algorithms.
Yeah.
So you've got this book of algorithms that you're then turning and using as a weapon to sort of impress them and amaze them even more.
The book's great quality as well. It looks absolutely 100% genuine. I know, you know, I produce Pi Revelations and I like the fact that it's got that history of Pi at the front. This has got the history of the Rubik Cube. So if a spectator picks it up and they look through it, it looks absolutely genuine. I know Kevin's going to have his own stand at Blackpool this year. It's another first look. There's a few items this week that we've kind of bumped to the front of the review pile, like Puck's sort of Unbalance. Craig's Evoke, which is absolutely unbelievable. I'm sure more performances are going to be shared in that launch group very, very soon. And, you know, the dropper as well. Hanson Chen always has so many great items at Blackpool. I'm starting to get excited about Blackpool now. You're not there this year.
I want to be excited, but I'm not there. I'm flying back to America in a couple of days. But I want to be at Blackpool. I'll hopefully be at the next one.
It is going to be brilliant. I'm going to pick at least one event to go and see at Blackpool, even though we're normally busy on the dealer stand. I think that one event I'm going to go and see is Tom Wright's show, because he's a friend of mine, and I know he's working really, really hard on his comedy show. He is brilliant. He's so funny. I'm really looking forward to seeing that show. So I think that's the one event I'm going to pick this year and go and see. Last year or the year before, I think it was the one competition I went to go and see. But I always pick one event. I think it's going to be Tom's show that I'm going to go and see this year. Can't wait for Blackpool. If you're in the area, come and see us at the Northamptonshire Magicians Club on that Monday before. But until then, and for the last time in quite a long time, because he's only just renewed his visa for the next 10 years, I'm Dave.
I'm Sean.
We'll see you next time on the Wizard Magic Review.